Welcome to our YouTube channel 24/7 AP Library. Today we are with you with English grammar topic. The topic is active and passive voice. In English grammar, the voice of a verb describes its relationship with the subject, object, or any other element in a sentence. The verb can be in the active voice or in the passive voice. When the subject is the doer of the action or verb, the verb is in the active voice. Like a sentence is given on your screen: Arun teaches Rahul. Here in this sentence, Arun is the subject. Arun is the doer of the action. Who is teaching? Rahul. So this is in active voice. When the subject is the receiver of the action or verb, the verb is said to be in the passive voice. Like Rahul is taught by Arun. Here Arun is the receiver of the action. So this is in passive voice. Let's discuss about both the kinds, active and passive voice. Two sentences are given on your screen. The cat drank the milk. Second sentence is, the milk was drunk by the cat. In these two sentences, same message has been given, but the structure of the sentence is different. The first sentence is in active voice and the second sentence is in passive voice. Both are giving the same message, but structure of the sentence is different in these sentences. First of all, active voice. Active voice is used to show the significance of the doer or subject over the object. The verb shows that the subject does something. Active voice is the subject-centered sentence. Subject is the central part of this sentence, because subject is the doer of the action. The structure of the sentence of active voice is subject plus verb plus object. In some of the sentences, helping verbs can be there. In some of the sentences, prepositions can be there. But the basic structure is subject plus verb plus object. Like sentence is given, Arun teaches Rahul. Here Arun is the central part of this sentence, because Arun is doing an action. So this is in active voice. Now passive voice, used to show the significance of the object over the doer or subject. It shows that something is done to the subject. The sentences of passive voice are object-centered. Object is the central part in this sentence. formation of sentence in passive voice is subject plus helping verb plus past participle form, means third form of the verb, plus preposition like by we use in most of the sentences, plus object. So this is the structure of the sentence in passive voice. Like the cat drank the milk. This is the sentence of active voice. The milk was drunk by the cat. This is in passive voice. Here we have the milk as a subject, was as helping verb, drunk is the past participle form of verb, and at the end we can use by the cat. By preposition will be there, and plus object, that will be the cat. The example of passive voice: Rahul is taught by Arun. Here we have Rahul as subject in this sentence, but it was object in active voice. Is as helping verb, then verb past participle means third form of the verb, then preposition like by we use in most of the sentences, but we use some other prepositions also in passive voice. Next is object, that is Arun in this sentence. Now we will discuss about the change in the position of subject and object. When we change any sentence from active voice to passive voice, or passive voice to active voice, on your screen two sentences are there. First is in active voice and second one is in passive voice. The first sentence is he drew the picture. In this sentence we have he as subject, the picture as object. In second sentence, that is in passive voice, the picture was drawn by him. Here we have the picture as subject in this sentence and him as object in passive voice. When we change any sentence of active voice into passive voice, then the subject will be object in passive voice and the object in the active voice will be subject in passive voice. Now we will discuss about change in verb when we change any sentence of active voice into passive voice or passive voice to active voice. The same sentence is there, he drew the picture. But in passive voice, we have written the picture was drawn by him. Drew, that is second form of the verb, past form of the verb. In passive voice, we use helping verb plus third form of the verb, that is past participle. The object of the active verb becomes the subject of the passive verb. Here on your screen we have the example of active verb. A doctor prescribes medicines. Here we have a doctor as subject, prescribes that is active verb, and medicines as an object. If this sentence we will change into passive voice, medicines that was object in active voice sentence, here it will be subject. Medicines are prescribed by a doctor. In this sentence, we have medicines as subject and a doctor as an object. Now we will discuss about some changes in pronoun when we change any sentence from active to passive or passive to active. These pronouns we have discussed in previous video. Some pronouns are used at the place of subject and some are used at the place of object. If you want to clear your doubts about pronoun, watch that video. Here, if we have I as a subject in active voice, then we use me as object in passive voice. And if we have me in active voice as an object, then we use I in passive voice as a subject. Same in case of we and us. Same in case of you and you. The word will remain same. This is used same at the place of subject and object. Same change will be there in case of he and him. He will be changed into him and him will be changed into he. Same, she will be changed into her and her will be changed into she. They will be changed into them and them will be changed into they. So these are some pronouns which we use as subject or as objects. So be careful about the use of pronoun as subject or as object. Now we will discuss some tense wise changes when we change any sentence from active voice to passive voice. In active voice, first we have to identify the tense of the sentence. If the sentence is in present indefinite, we use is, am, are plus third form of the verb in passive voice. If the sentence is in past indefinite, we use was or were as helping verb plus third form of the verb. If we have future indefinite tense in the sentence of active voice, then we use will or shall plus be plus third form of the verb. Same if we have present continuous tense in the sentence of active voice, we use is, am, are plus being plus third form of the verb. If we have past continuous tense in active voice, then we use was or were plus being plus third form of the verb. Same in case of present perfect. If we have present perfect tense in active voice, we use has or have plus been plus third form of the verb. If we have past perfect tense in active voice, we use had plus been plus third form of the verb. in future perfect. We use will or shall in passive voice plus have plus been plus third form of the verb. Modal verbs. In case of modal verbs, we use same modal verb in passive voice which is used in active voice, but with same modal verb we use be plus third form of the verb. Some of the tenses cannot be changed into passive voice, like future continuous. Future continuous tense we can't change into passive voice. Present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous, future perfect continuous. These four tenses are there which are out of the rules of passive voice, which we can't change into passive voice. So only 8 tenses are there which we can use, which we can change into passive voice. Now, imperative sentences that are in the form of instructions, commands. In active voice, if we have the sentence "speak the truth," for this sentence we have 3 methods to change it into passive voice. The first method is the truth should be spoken. Subject plus should be plus third form of the verb. The second method is let plus subject plus be plus third form of the verb. Like in this sentence, let the truth be spoken. And the third method is by using you are advised to, you are requested to, you are ordered to, by using these type of phrases. Like here we have you are advised to speak the truth, because this is an advice. So we have used you are advised to speak the truth. We can change imperative sentences in these 3 ways to passive voice. So you can use any of these methods. When please or kindly word is used in active voice, then we use you are requested to in passive voice, and we don't use please or kindly words in passive voice. We use you are requested to. When command is given, command or order is given in active voice, then we use you are ordered to in passive voice. So these are some ways to change imperative sentences from active voice to passive voice. Now interrogative sentences. In interrogative sentences, the place of W family and helping verbs remains unchanged. W family word and helping verb will be remain at the same place. For example, we have the sentence, do you drink milk? The passive voice of this sentence will be, is milk drunk by you? Second example we have of these type of sentences, who broke the flower vase? This is the sentence of active voice. By whom was the flower vase broken? This is the sentence of passive voice. Here in these kind of sentences, if who is there as a question word in active voice. We use whom in passive voice. And by we use with whom. By preposition we use with whom. Now, transitive and intransitive verbs in passive voice. Only transitive verbs can be changed into passive voice. Like, he writes a letter. This is the sentence of active voice. A letter is written by him. This is the sentence of passive voice. In transitive verbs, we have the object in these type of sentences, so we can change it into passive voice. But intransitive verbs cannot be changed into passive voice. Here we have one example of intransitive verb. He writes neatly. So this sentence is without object, so we can't change it into passive voice. Now, the process or recipe form. In process or recipe form, we use in most of the exercises present tense and past tense. If we are using present tense, we use is or are plus past participle form of the verb. If we are using past tense in writing a recipe or process, we use was or were in passive voice and plus past participle form of the verb. Be careful about some points while writing a recipe or process in passive form, in passive voice. Use same tense in writing the whole process. Use prepositional phrase after the verb. Sometimes we have prepositional phrase in process or recipe form. Then use that prepositional phrase after the verb only. Here we have an exercise of this recipe form. Some instructions are given. How to cook rice. Wash the rice in clean water. Put it in a pan and fill it half with water. Place the pan on the stove. Boil it for some time. When all the water evaporates, take it off the stove. These are instructions. And in clean water, on the stove, for some time, off the stove. These are prepositional phrase in these instructions. Now, try to complete this process, which is given in the form of fill-ups. Cooking rice is very simple. The rice is washed in clean water. Here we have present tense in these two sentences. So now we will complete this process by using present tense only. Let's see the answers of this exercise. Cooking rice is very simple. First of all, the rice is washed in clean water. It is then put in a pan and filled half with water. Then the pan is placed on the stove. It is boiled for some time. When all the water evaporates, it is taken off the stove. Be careful about some points. We use third form or past participle form of the verb in all the sentences of passive voice. This is all about active and passive voice. We will be with you with some more English grammar topics on our channel. So stay tuned to our channel, subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for instant notifications for our next videos. Thanks for watching.